All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Anthony Ginsberg. He is the CEO of GinsGlobal. And Anthony, welcome back. Great to see you again.
Thanks, Steve. Great to see you.
Back once again with a look at what's going on in the Tech Megatrend ETF. And last time you and I talked about this, you talked about the successes that a lot of companies were seeing in the tech world. So let's get you to update where everyone's at right now. Are things looking as good as they were last time we chatted?
Well, actually, they're looking a little better because the Fed has paused. They've been expecting lower rates. We've seen a nice rebound in the tech megatrend. It's actually up over 11% just in the month of November. Year to date, it's closing on about a 30% gain. And I guess it's the global convergence, Steve, across a lot of these tech megatrends, from cybersecurity to cloud to robotics, as well as AI. Obviously, AI has been boosting our cloud holdings. We've also seen blockchain also have a nice run. I think one of the big things is this convergence, because you're seeing essentially AI adding about $2 trillion expectations are of new revenues and spending over the next 4 to 5 years. But that's boosting a lot of demand, not just in cloud, but also in gaming, social media. These things are converging. For example, gaming is increasingly moving to the phone, to the mobile. So social media is benefiting from video streaming, digital entertainment. So these things are no longer in separate silos, and that's why we think the mega trend, where we cover essentially, as you recall, 8 of these sub-themes and are rebalancing them and equally weighting them every 6 months with the top 15 players per sub-theme, that's really helped us, because we're not trying to bet just on one or two winners here. And the equal-weighted approach also means that we're not overweight just the Magnificent Seven, for example.
Yeah. Anthony, I'm wondering, there's been a lot of talk in the news recently about AI, specifically, you know, Microsoft and what they've been doing. Does that weigh a lot on people when you see a company like a Microsoft that's really pushing towards AI and helping the general market or the macro look of something like AI?
It's a good question. It's actually also filtered through to many other companies who felt that they had to play catch up. Obviously, we look at Google, we look at Oracle, we look at some of the other guys all jumping, and even Amazon has bought an AI player as well. I think the biggest issue with AI is most multinationals and even some of the SMMEs, the smaller guys that we hold, recognize they can't run these basically algorithms and these other automated programs internally. So it's pushed the outsourcing and it's pushed demand for both cloud and cybersecurity. So that's the tailwind behind those two. And then you get into areas where it overlaps, like social media or digital entertainment, where you're also seeing usages of AI algorithms, whether it's Netflix telling you what shows to watch over Thanksgiving. So I think the frenzy is not just linked to one area. A lot of us think, oh, it's just ChatGPT or it's just Bard. It's actually filtering through. And it's actually, this is 1999, 2000 possibly again, where you're getting really an inflection point where the usage of outsourcing and data centers is going to be taken to the next level, because most corporates just can't afford to run these sorts of programs at the speed that they want. Whether you're a Walmart, a Kmart, a healthcare company, you really need to find fast outsourcing sources to do this for you.
Yeah, I was also interested in reading in the report about chips, specifically chips for cars and electric vehicles. I found that pretty fascinating, considering that, you know, where that industry is at now and really where it has to go moving forward into, you know, as far away as 2035.
Yes, when we look at EVs, we actually look at these as computers on wheels or robots on wheels. And actually, the CHIPS Act that came out in the US, this is a massive boost for the likes of many of the semiconductor players who are now going to be onshoring. Of course, the big one, Taiwan Semiconductor, is also going to be moving a factory to the US. But you've got folks like Intel who are going to receive more than $10 billion of chip subsidies, Texas Instruments. So the whole ecosystem is actually benefiting also from the Inflation Reduction Act, this IRA Act, which is spending apparently $500 billion just in the next few years on EV charging stations. So the whole infrastructure has benefited from government spending as well as this whole boon in AI.
Yeah, I can imagine. Well, people are hoping the trend continues, so to speak. So good to see you again, Anthony. Thanks very much for the update. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Steve.
All right, there's Anthony Ginsberg, the CEO of GinsGlobal.